So how to make $100 per day. What this video is not going to be is me going through a list of 10 jobs that all pay an average of $100 per day. Instead, I'm going to show you the major paths you have to achieve this goal. Now, for a video like this, I probably have two kinds of audiences watching. The first are people that are financially savvy and they're interested in financial topics like this, and the other is a very desperate group of people that need money right now because they need to eat. So I'm gonna start with that group of people because they need the help. And I definitely feel for you if you're in that situation. And that's why I make these videos, to help people have a better financial life. But something you have to understand is that building wealth is a long-term thing. It's not something you can do overnight, but there are some actions you can take today to begin to realize that $100 per day. It's just that the immediate gratification path is usually less desirable long-term than the other paths. But the first thing anybody can do to generate $100 per day is actually to save $100 per day. So when it comes to expenses, this is an average right here. We can see the major expense is housing, followed by transportation, taxes, utilities, food, so on and so on. When it comes to housing, an easy way to get this down is to rent a room. You can do this on Craigslist, or you can room with a friend. Or if you want to be really creative, you can live in an RV or a tiny house or some other unconventional style of living that ultimately can save you quite a bit of money and be pretty fun. But let's move on to transportation. This is something you have a bit more control over versus your housing. And here in the US, transportation means having a vehicle. The average car payment in the US is $563 for new vehicles, $397 for used, and $450 for leased vehicles. And all of this is completely unnecessary. Having a $400 a month car payment is ridiculous. And if you're looking to save money, this is the first thing you should get rid of. And the traditional advice here is to not buy new vehicles. So instead, buy a used 10-year-old Toyota Camry. It's going to be reliable and cheap, and that is a good way to go. Now, if you want to save even more money, you should completely get rid of your vehicle. And if you choose to do this, not only will you not have a car payment, but you will not have to pay for insurance or gas. The average cost of gas per month is about $250, and car insurance is roughly $120 per month. So between a car payment, insurance, gas, we can see why transportation is 14% of the average budget. Now, a practical way to eliminate a vehicle from your life is to actually invest in an e-bike. And e-bikes today are becoming more and more popular. I see them all the time in my town. And if you go to a city like New York or LA, they're all over the place. So the benefits here are e-bikes are very cheap. They're not as cheap as a regular bike, but they have lots of advantages to compensate for that. So they're full-on vehicles that you can use to commute, get around town in a very cheap, efficient, and fun way. Now, e-bikes were actually so compelling to me that I actually made my own back in August. It's now the beginning of October, and I have to say, since getting my e-bike back in August, I've bought gasoline one time. So from firsthand experience, e-bikes are an awesome, affordable way to go if you want to save a lot of money on transportation. Okay, but now let's get back to actually making an additional $100 per day. And I'm going to begin with the most immediate gratification path. So if you need money right now, this is definitely going to be the way to go. But as the video goes on, I'm going to show more and more lucrative paths that, after you build them up, can generate you potentially a lot more than $100 per day in a very passive way. Okay, so the first path is a job. If you want money right now, you have to sell your time in exchange for money. If you want to specifically earn $100 per day in a 9-to-5, 40-hour per week job, that translates to a job that pays $36,500 per year. And that's really not that impossible to achieve. That's an entry-level job. It's not going to be the funnest or most fulfilling job in the world, but it's going to be the fastest way to generate a consistent $100 per day. And if you split that into an hourly wage, you want to look for something that's roughly $17.50 per hour. Okay, so the next path is very similar to a job, but it gives you a bit more control because technically you are a freelancer. And this is delivering food with DoorDash or Uber Eats or any of your favorite delivery apps. So this is still a job. You're doing a task in exchange for cash, but there's a lot more freedom here because you can choose when and where you want to do this. And from my research, you can make roughly $18 per active hour doing DoorDash. And if you remember, to make $100 a day, you need 8 hours of $17.50 per hour. So this could work. Now, if you took my advice from earlier, you can actually use an e-bike to very efficiently do DoorDash. There's lots of great videos on YouTube of people using e-bikes to deliver food for DoorDash and the other services. This is a great video you're watching right now. I'll leave it linked down below, but he shows you how he goes about doing this, as well as how much money he made. It's not as comfortable as using a car to do this, but you're going to have next to no expenses, so it's going to make this whole operation more profitable. Okay, now moving up to the next tier to generate income, this is a significantly more advantageous economic model, although it's not going to give you immediate gratification. This is going to take work because it is an actual business, and this is e-commerce. And this is a field that I have a lot of experience in because I actually sell two products on Amazon myself, and Amazon is the main platform to do this, along with Shopify and your own website. So within e-commerce, there's a few different business models you can achieve. The first is retail arbitrage, and this is a very basic business model, but essentially you go to places like Target, Walmart, and you try to buy products that then you can sell on Amazon for more money. But I don't think that's an actual long-term successful business model. I think if you want to be serious with e-commerce, you have to be like any other business and solve a problem. So you have to do market research and identify a niche and a product field that's currently not meeting demand, and you have to come in and satisfy that demand. My favorite way of achieving this is to improve upon existing products. So I'm sure we've all used products before that have some kind of a flaw or a pain point, and you think to yourself, why doesn't this product have X, Y, and Z? That would make it so much better. And identifying those opportunities to fix a problem is exactly how you can build a business. You could also read reviews on Amazon, see what people complain about, and make a product that fixes those problems. So this business is going to take a lot of initial time, effort, and capital because you do have to buy the inventory. But if you are successful and you create a product that actually fixes problems and brings value to people's lives, you will be rewarded for that. Now moving on to the next path, this is a blog or a YouTube channel. And the reason why I think this is a little bit better than e-commerce is because it's a digital product instead of a physical product. So you don't have to buy inventory, you don't have to ship it, you don't have to pay for storage, and a digital product could be consumed one time or a million times with no added cost. A physical product isn't quite like that. It's not all positive news though. I have to say the downside to YouTube and blogging and just having digital content is that it takes a lot of time to make that digital content. And much like with e-commerce, this is a product even though it's digital. So you have to be better than the competition. You have to solve a problem that other people aren't addressing. But if you can achieve all of that, a digital product is way more economically favorable than a physical product. Now the final business is Airbnb. This is extremely lucrative and it's really taken off in the past couple of years. And I think this trend is just going to continue more into the future. So Airbnb, of course, just allows you to leverage an existing asset you have to generate income. So the most common way people start doing this is by renting out a spare bedroom in their house. And this can generate easily $100 per night. And if you already have the asset like a house, Airbnb is just allowing you to leverage it to generate additional income. And that's a great thing. Even if you don't have an extra bedroom, you can furnish and rent out a garage, a basement. You can get very creative with this and very fast generate a lot of money. And of course, then you could expand and acquire more properties just for the purpose of short-term rentals, which is a very lucrative business. And the final option I have for you guys is to invest in the market and collect interest or dividends. If you're interested in this topic, watch all of my previous videos because I talk about this all the time. My favorite single ETF for dividends and true passive income is JEPI. JEPI offers around a 7.5% dividend yield, and they pay out monthly, which is very nice. So for every $100 you put into JEPI, you're going to have an annual income of $7.50, roughly speaking. So I hope this video helped somebody out there. And the best way to utilize this information is to combine them. So have a day job, have a side hustle. That side hustle could be e-commerce. It could be a digital product like blogging or YouTube. If you have a spare room or an unused basement in your house, rent it out on Airbnb to generate additional income, and then invest your money into the stock market to generate additional passive income in the form of dividends and interest. If you guys are still watching and enjoyed, give the video a like, subscribe to the channel, all that YouTube stuff, and I'll see you in the next one.